Hi, I'm Laura. Welcome to Essential Oils for Beginners from Laura Kimbrell Wellness. Today we're going to talk about all the basics of essential oils so you can learn what essential oils are, how we use them, and what kind of areas that you can use oils in your life to improve things like your emotional health and your physical health. So I'm glad you joined me today. Get comfy and get ready to learn some cool stuff. So what are essential oils? They are becoming more and more popular, and you may have heard of essential oils. You may have even tried some, maybe from the grocery store or the health food store. Essential oils are just the pure extracts of different plants. And the basis of modern medicine is the oils that come from the different plants and the compounds within it. So people have been relying on essential oils for hundreds to thousands of years to provide different needs, meet different needs in their life. The definition of an essential oil is just a natural, highly concentrated compound found in the root, bark, seeds, flowers, or other areas of a plant. These compounds are very, very pure. When in the oil form, they're 50 to 70 times more concentrated than you would find them just in the herb or the plant alone. These oils give the plants their aroma, like a lavender, the flower. If you smell a flower from a lavender plant, then that's what a lavender essential oil smells like. These smells can do a lot of things. They can attract pollinators to the plants so that the sweet smell of an orange blossom is going to attract bees so that the flowers can be pollinated and oranges can bloom. The essential oils also serve as a plant's immune system to protect the plants from really harsh environmental conditions and insects and other pests that may try to harm the plant or the tree or the grass. Essential oils are known as volatile aromatic compounds. What this means in plain English is that the compounds evaporate very easily. So when you open a bottle of essential oil, you're going to smell it right away. These tiny, tiny organic molecules quickly transform from a liquid or a solid state into gas when they reach room temperature. And so that's why when you think essential oils, probably the first thing that comes to mind is their fragrance and aromatherapy, because aroma means smell. When we look throughout history, there are lots of records of ancient people using essential oils. We find that people were using essential oils all over the world. In Egypt, Greece, Rome, India, China, and France, they're all well-documented historical use of essential oils that go back to thousands of years ago. And so that is, that's a really neat safety record. Why do we use essential oils why can we use essential oils to manage our mood? For one thing, they're absolutely natural and safe. When you smell a rose and you get that the sweet, sweet scent, and it's very calming and uplifting. That is a positive feedback that nature gives you. When we smell, let's say, the odor of a skunk, most people would probably react very negatively to that and know that that was a signal to get away. Nature also gives us wonderful smelling smells to attract us and to entice us to use these things because they're beneficial to our body. So they can, they generate really quick responses, and it's a very simple way to manage our emotions. And you may not know this, but when we smell a natural scent like an essential oil, those molecules attach themselves to the olfactory nerve in the nose. When they do that, they send chemical signals to the center of our brain. That's called the limbic area. And the limbic area of our brain contains the amygdala and the hippocampus. And this is the part of our brain where our memories are controlled, our learning, and our emotions. And so you can affect those things very, very quickly, instantaneously with essential oils. If you're wanting to support memory and learning, then you could diffuse oils like wild orange and rosemary while you're studying or you're trying to learn new things. If your mood needs to be lifted, wild orange is also a great mood lifting oil. If you need to feel a bit calmer and more relaxed, then diffusing lavender is a great way to do that. So it's just a very simple, natural way to manage your emotions that I've come to rely on a lot with my family. I use essential oils basically in every room of my house. I cook with them. I love having my ginger oil in the kitchen because I live on a farm way out in the country, miles and miles from the nearest large grocery store. And I don't always have fresh ginger root. So when I'm making my stir fry and I want ginger, I just add a drop of ginger oil to my sesame oil and toss it in. I like to spike my salsa with some extra cilantro oil and lime oil. And so not only am I getting the flavor, but I'm getting lots of antioxidants and other health benefits from it. Essential oils can support your digestion. They're great for your hair and skin. And doTERRA has some amazing hair and skincare products that I do not want to live without. They provide wonderful immune support. You know, I say essential oils give my family super suits. And so we just have rock star immune systems. They're great for household cleaning, despite what the Clorox lady says on TV. Oh my gosh, I just crack up every time I see that commercial because she says, you want something that kills dysentery like bleach. Well, bleach is full of toxic chemicals. The fumes from it are carcinogenic. They cause respiratory distress. You can absolutely clean and kill germs with essential oils and be just as confident that you're getting the kind of kill that the bleach people want you to believe you can't get. They're great for everyday things like head and neck tension and discomfort, seasonal and environmental discomforts, you know, when those things creep in the spring and the fall and things like that, you can totally take care of it naturally. It's just so many ways that you can use essential oils in your life and get rid of some really nasty, toxic chemicals and drugs and side effects. All right, so how are some ways that you can use essential oils to benefit your health? I have 4 children, and skin irritations and little scratches and boo-boos are common. We always use our oils for that. We often rely on lavender and melaleuca oil in our skin irritations. Promoting healthy digestion, peppermint is great for that. Even the digestive blend called Digest Zen, it is amazing. You can just rub it on the tummy and it supports good digestion from entry to exit. That's what I like to tell people. Excuse me. Supporting healthy immune function is something we do year-round, and it makes such a difference. My family is just so much healthier than it was from when before we knew about essential oils, and that's On Guard. We use On Guard daily on the bottoms of our feet, but we also use things like On Guard foaming hand wash, and that kills the germs and boosts our immune function. We use the On Guard toothpaste, which gives us white, shiny, clean teeth and great oral health while also supporting our immune system. You can use oils to help you sleep restfully. That sleep is one of the most important things you can give your body to prevent aging and disease, because sleep is when your body repairs itself. So getting good sleep is so important. We use lavender, and we love Serenity restful blend in our diffuser at night. What we'll do is we'll put a drop or two in our hands and rub it together and take a deep smell from our hands and then rub it on the bottoms of our feet and the back of our neck. And I'll put a few drops in the diffuser by the bed as well and just have really, really nice, restful, restorative sleep. Alleviating occasional stomach upset, you know, there's just so many ways that essential oils can handle the daily issues that come up in our family life. Now, for the emotional benefits of essential oil, they're amazing. Oils can be very, very calming depending on which one you choose. Lavender, bergamot, the Balance Grounding Blend, I love that. I call that the Mom Doesn't Yell oil because it just makes me feel so calm and grounded, and that's a hard feeling to come by when you got four kiddos running around and lots going on. Essential oils can also be very energizing. You know, the afternoon, if you feel that slump in your energy, I love to put a drop of wild orange and peppermint, one of each, in my hands, rub it together, and just take a good deep breath of that. It just perks me up and energizes me and helps me focus and go on with some zip in my step for the rest of the day. Oils can be very, very soothing. When emotions are high and someone's feeling upset or irritated or overstimulated, I love the Peace blend for that from the Emotional Aromatherapy line. That's really good. I use that often with my children, my boys, when they're fighting. So where's the peace? And I do that, and everybody kind of calms down. Renewing, citrus oils are great for that. Invigorating, there's citrus bliss and uplifting. There's just so many possibilities. The passion, the motivate, those blends, those are all really, really great. And I keep those roller balls in my purse all the time. So how can you use your essential oils to manage your emotions? You can use oils three ways. You can use them aromatically, and that is just as easy as smelling them from the bottle. It doesn't have to be fancy. You can use an essential oil diffuser as well, which has water, and you place a few drops of essential oil in it, and the ultrasound technology makes the essential oil come out in a mist in particle sizes that are easily used by your body. You can apply essential oils topically, and you can take them internally as well. And so with doTERRA, on taking essential oils internally, you can tell if by reading the label if an oil is intended to be used internally or not. And do not use oils internally that have a safety cap on them. That's kind of the goof-proof way of saying these will upset your stomach, like the Deep Blue Soothing Blend, as well as wintergreen oil, birch oil. Those have safety caps on them to remind you that they're not to be used internally. Okay, so this is what we talked about briefly a while ago. Aromatic use of essential oils can be really, really simple. You can just simply mix a few drops of oil and water in a spray bottle and mist over your carpet or your bed linens. I like to spray mattresses with a little bit of essential oil mixed in water when I'm changing the sheets. If you have some carpet that's stinky, or even your drapes, your furniture, you can do that. Add a drop or two to a homemade surface cleanser, and you can find recipes for those on doTERRA.com. You can just put a drop in your hand, put your palms, rub your hands together, and just put them over your hands and your nose and inhale. So it doesn't have to be difficult. Just keep it simple. Great places to use essential oils topically would be the back of the neck, forehead, and temples. So if you have head or neck tension, that would be a great place. The chest is where I like to use oils for emotional purposes. And then the abdomen is a great place to apply oils when you're trying to support digestion. The arms, legs, bottoms of the feet, pulse points, those are great areas where they'll be, the oils will be easily absorbed into the blood and taken throughout the body. You should avoid ever using essential oils on the skin around the eyes. And my rule of thumb is no closer to the eye than the eye socket bone. So the bone that's under your eyebrow and then that goes good well below your eye. Don't put oils any closer to your eyes than that, and never put any oils inside your ear. Even the gentlest oils can rupture the eardrum, so you never, ever, ever want to put oils inside your ears or your eyes. Let's be safe about it. Whenever you are taking a bath, I love to put a few drops of oil in hot water. I also like to add Epsom salts to it. And that just is a great relaxing way to soak. You can also make the topical use more effective by using a compress. And that's just as simple as a hot or cold cloth. And then add some oil and apply to desired areas. So if you have, like an uncomfortable sore muscle or something, you could make a hot compress and apply a couple of drops of marjoram oil or deep blue oil to it, and just lay that over the area for 15 minutes or so. You can mix essential oils with a carrier lotion or your moisturizer and apply it to the skin. And doTERRA has an amazing hand and body unscented lotion that is in the spa line. It's intended to be a carrier lotion. And the neat thing is, if you have a selection of oils, then you have unlimited possibilities on the scents of your hand lotion. You just put a dime size squeeze of lotion in your hand, add 1 to 2 drops of essential oil, and there you go. You've got custom scented lotion. When using oils internally, you can place a couple of drops in a veggie capsule and take it with water. You can add an essential oil to a glass of water or other drink. And the general rule for that is 1 drop to 4 ounces of a beverage. Or you could place a few drops of oil in a small amount of yogurt or applesauce or even honey. When we have a scratchy throat around our house, what I do is I put a spoon of honey and then I add 1 to 2 drops of On Guard in that. And the honey is very soothing and it helps get the On Guard in there and coating the throat. So there's all kinds of good tricks for that. What are some oils you should start with? I think everybody should have a bottle of lemon oil. Good old lemon oil is amazing. It removes the adhesive residue like nobody's business. Like if you take a label off of a bottle and it's sticky, put 1 drop of lemon oil on there and just rub it with a paper towel or even your finger. And it comes right off. It's amazing. Lemon makes a great cleanser for surfaces. You can also use it to create an uplifting mood when you use it in your diffuser. And I think everybody should drink a little bit of lemon oil in water every day. It makes a great refreshing beverage, and lemon supports our body's natural detoxification processes. So it's really a good healthy thing to do every day, and it tastes great. Lavender. We all love lavender because it helps us to sleep. But did you know that lavender is really great for the appearance of the skin and it helps with skin irritations? Lavender is also a very wonderful topical analgesic, meaning that it soothes topical pain. So I make a boo-boo spray for when my kids fall down and get cuts and scrapes on their knees and elbows. That is carrier oil with a little bit of lavender oil and melaleuca oil on it. And we put it in a spray bottle, We spray it on boo-boos. The melaleuca takes care of the environmental threats. The lavender is very soothing to the skin and relieving of the discomfort there. So it's a great duo for any boo-boos. You can diffuse lavender anytime during the day or evening. In the evening, it helps you sleep. But if you're feeling tension or you just need a little help relaxing during the day, put some lavender in your diffuser during the day. And definitely you can use it at night and even put it on your bedding or pillows, as well as the bottom of your feet to help you rest. Peppermint. Oh, the smell of peppermint just makes my mouth water. You can diffuse peppermint to help you have clear breathing and open airways. It's also very invigorating. If you want fresh breath for hours and good oral hygiene, put one drop of peppermint oil in your mouth. And you can also add a few drops of peppermint oil to your shampoo or conditioner, and it will really, your scalp will just love it. It's good for your hair. It's very stimulating to your scalp as well, and it feels good. You can download this great ebook on doTERRA.com. Whenever you go there and you look for the resources, it's got more information on how to use essential oils if you're a beginner. And even if you're not a beginner, it's got great information there. So I hope you learned something today that will benefit you. And if you would like to learn more, I would love to support you. At Laura Kimbrell Wellness, I'm very passionate about education and support, and I have a closed Facebook group that my team can benefit from, and I continue to educate people there and support people there. So thank you for visiting. If someone sent you, by all means, contact that person if you would like to learn more and get started with essential oils. And if you found my site online, please contact me. And I would love to help you with any questions you have, to give you a wellness consult, and to help you transform your wellness care to a more natural and safe and effective way. They really work, and we just love them. Thank you for your time. Bye-bye.